On a night out while looking for love, there's nothing like having the support of a friend. Known sometimes as a wingman or wingwoman, the term originates from fighter jet pilots, where the wingman's job is to support and protect the leading pilot. This same dynamic is applied when a friend needs support approaching potential partners. But what's the science behind this strategy, and do wingmen actually work? First things first, you look better in a group than you do on your own. One study had participants evaluate pictures of 300 people and found that faces were significantly more attractive when they were shown in a group photo compared to the same faces shown on their own. Another good tactic a squad can use is that of a wild turkey. Wild turkeys attract mates in a coalition where one turkey is dominant and the other turkeys are helpers. These helper turkeys wear less colorful plumage, making the dominant one look like a better catch. And this strategy almost doubles the reproductive success compared to those turkeys who ride solo. Even male fireflies work together to attract ladies. Fireflies use bioluminescent flashes to signal a mate, and when male fireflies synchronize their flashes, females responded 82% of the time compared to 3% of the time with asynchronous flashes. So maybe it's time for your squad to think of a coordinated dance? Especially if you're the wingman to a lance-tailed mannequin. Males of this species team up in pairs, performing intricate dances, including leaping over one another. But within the group, there is an alpha and a beta, and the beta never gets lucky. So why be a wingman? A study that tracked and analyzed DNA of 457 birds found that beta birds, after learning from the alphas, had a better chance of becoming an alpha the following year. These strategies are often used among males, but what about females? Across cultures, human women tend to be more selective or choosy than men when it comes to partnerships, though significant variation does exist among sexes. After all, females expend more resources in pregnancy, making it important that they choose a partner more selectively. When asked to describe their courtship strategies, interestingly, women were actually more likely to use cooperative techniques than men, but these techniques were used to avoid partners where there was no romantic interest. Again, this certainly varies from person to person, and these studies also only focused on heterosexual behavior. How far will the squad go for you? Are they willing to lie? It turns out the closer relationship you have with someone, the more likely you are to lie to make them look good. This is why going out with your best friends to the bar can help boost your image. Of course, looking for love or a fling while in the company of friends is fun and often effective, but just remember that finding romance doesn't need to be a strategic game where you have to trick someone. If you just be yourself, you're more likely to find someone who likes you for you. Special thanks to Audible for supporting this episode and giving you a free 30-day trial at audible.com/ASAP. This week, we wanted to recommend the book The Invention of Nature by Andrea Wolf, which is a fascinating investigation of the relationship between environments around the world and their connectedness with humanity. You can get a free 30-day trial at audible.com/ASAP and choose from a massive selection. We love them as they're great when you're on the go. And subscribe for more weekly science videos.